My name is Taylor Ward. We're at Dr. Kosuri's lab in the Molecular Biology Institute at UCLA, and I work with yeast. So what I do with yeast is I take the genome, and I pick a spot, a gene, it encodes the protein, you know, what we're made out of, and I can put any sort of DNA that I want there. Once I have that DNA in there, I can express it. So you can make insulin this way with bacteria. It has a lot of applications, so it can help a lot of people. So I'm from a small town in Maine. That's all the way on the other side of the United States, top north corner. So it's cold and it's wet, but it's really pretty. So I grew up there. So I first became interested in science when I was in high school. I was pre-law before. I was like, yeah, I'm good at writing. I'll be a lawyer. You know, I like to argue. And then I took this biology class, and this teacher just sparked something inside of me. And then I came to Sacramento, California. I went to junior college for a couple years. I'm a transfer, and then I got into UCLA. And now I'm a master's student here in Dr. Kosuri's lab. My mission in the lab is to work with these yeast cells, and I want to transform them with a plasmid, a bit of DNA from bacteria. So I do a lot of working with liquid cultures. I use an odometer a lot, so it allows you take a cuvette, you insert it, you close it, you press measure, and it tells you how many cells are in there. So I work with that a lot. I work with, you know, incubators to grow my cells. And what I'm really just doing is taking something from bacteria, putting it into yeast, and then trying to make sure it integrates, and then I can go from there and express whatever I want. The practical application is once we get, we call it a landing pad, what we can do is we can insert whatever DNA we would like in there. So the end result is to be able to express a protein, you know, even RNA, and just express whatever we'd like from this locus and be able to control that expression. So people that have diabetes have a problem with not enough insulin, or their cells can't recognize insulin, so they can't take up any sugar. So being able to have a source of insulin like this in bacteria, because it would express a massive amount. You can get tons of insulin, any protein you want, overexpress it from this, you know, one little petri dish of bacteria. And then you can use that to make these cheap insulin replacements for people with diabetes that can help them, you know, not have such an issue with blood sugar and everything, which can be dangerous for them. And not only does it have applications for disease, it also has applications for hunger, to put it simply, because we can also take things like rice or other plants, and we can put in maybe a missing amino acid or a missing vitamin that can then make this cheap food source so that people will not starve. I came to this kind of research very late in my career. It's very cliche, but it really is, the imagination is your limit, you know? You get to start with this base knowledge, like we know A, B, and C about this thing, and you can just take it and just run from there. It's fairly rewarding, you know, you work with a lot of great people. It's not like, you know, you're in a little cubicle by yourself, hunched over your benchtop. It's just, there's so many applications. It constantly challenges you, you know, constantly makes your brain cells work. It's really, I don't think there's anything else that is quite like being a scientist and working in a field like this. I can't see myself doing anything else. I really can't. It's awesome. Being a scientist is great.